Hello everyone and welcome. In this video we're going to be talking about two of the methods which Volvo is using to eliminate turbo lag. Now I personally don't think turbo lag is that cool, and it seems Volvo doesn't either. Some people don't seem to mind it, but I think, you know, the thing is, when you ask a car to do something and it takes a while to do it, that's not as exciting as when you ask a car to do something and it does it immediately. So when you floor it and you wait for that turbo to spool up, not that cool. Volvo seems to be on the same page. So one of the technologies which they have is called PowerPulse, and this is used on a sequential turbo diesel engine which they make. And basically the way it works is you have an air compressor. This is powered by an electric motor. That electric motor fills up an air tank with high pressure air. It's pulling that air directly from your intake filter, so clean air is being used, and then it stores it in that tank and it waits for you to floor it. So once you floor it, that throttle activation opens up a valve that allows for that compressed air to then be forced into the exhaust manifold, where it then spools up the turbo. So I've just drawn a single turbo setup. The actual engine they use is a twin turbo, a sequential turbo. So this would be feeding a smaller turbo, and then that exhaust gas would feed a larger turbo, which you'd be pulling air in from. So basically you send in that compressed air immediately when you floor it, so you don't have to wait for those exhaust gases to build up to spool up that turbo. That gives you a much better response time. And then, you know, after you've floored it, things like that, this tank is going to automatically start refilling itself in order to be ready for the next time where you don't have exhaust pressure built up and you need to get into that quick power, that quick turbo boost. Now again, looking at the actual design, this is using a sequential turbo setup. So when you open up that valve and it releases that pressure to help spool up that turbo, it spools up the smaller turbo, which is then feeding a larger turbo in there in order to have, you know, a good power range across a wide RPM range. Now, Volvo has mentioned that by the year 2019, they're going to have electrified their entire lineup. So there'll be at least one electric motor in all of their setups. They'll still have, you know, gasoline, perhaps diesel options, but they're going to be electrifying everything for better efficiency. And one of the cool things about doing this is it also helps to reduce turbo lag. So one of their examples is the T8 twin engine, which has a supercharged and turbocharged engine. So you've got that supercharger for that immediate response and good low end torque, and then you've got that turbocharger for the higher RPM range to keep that torque. And you also have an electric motor. So this is a plug-in hybrid that's supercharged and turbocharged. Basically, they just threw every technology at it. And it's cool because, you know, that electric motor then means that you're going to have that instant torque, that instant response. The supercharger helps you with that response, so you don't notice that delay of that turbocharger spooling up because you're covering it up with a supercharger and you're also covering it up with an electric motor. So very cool technology that is coming out of Volvo, you know, different ways to reduce turbo lag, make these cars more exciting to drive, and also at the same time, you know, like with this electric example, making it more efficient as well. So thank you guys for watching, and if you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave them below. If you'd like to learn more about turbocharger setups, twin turbos, sequential turbos, check out the links right here.